My name is Luis Vega. I'm a teacher of Ashtanga Yoga. And this is my philosophy behind my teaching. The meaning of the word yoga is union. Union between our physical world and our spiritual world. Yoga was originally created as a meditation tool, something for our mind, our soul, and our body. The practice of Ashtanga Vinyasa Yoga was discovered in 1900, and when it came to Europe and America in the 70s and 80s, students started to question why the series was so methodical and why you should follow in that particular order. And they start changing the series. There are many reasons why students change the series. One of them is that they don't know why they shouldn't change. But more often, practitioners avoid asanas that are either too easy or too challenging, or they find the practice too repetitive. If you change the series, then it becomes something different from Ashtanga. So you have to change the name of the practice. Nowadays, there are many types of dynamic yoga which are based on Ashtanga Vinyasa yoga. The main difference between them and Ashtanga is that there is not a memorized sequence anymore. And without this, there is no emphasis on the meditation side of the practice. It turns to asana practice. In my opinion, some of these modern dynamic styles of yoga have lost their connection to the meditation and the spiritual side of the practice by placing too much emphasis on the asana, physical part, which is just one of the eight limbs of yoga. The biggest challenge in the practice of yoga is to be present. And if you are present, even if you do the same thing 10 times, every time should feel unique, so there is never repetition. Practicing yoga as a meditation rather than a physical exercise allows you to become present in the moment. There are a number of things which, when they are combined, will make the experience meditative. The first thing, a sequence of asanas that you can learn to memorize, so there is no concern about what posture comes next, as it will come naturally. Then a breath which connects every single movement, every single moment into that sequence in a precise kind of way. And then the drishti, which is the focus point, literally the point of your gaze. And finally, bandhas, the energy locks, which should be engaged throughout the practice. When you bring all those four elements together, you're practicing a meditative yoga. And you find it takes you to a different place. Within the philosophy of yoga, there's a relation to the cycle of life, death, and rebirth. Some students and practitioners believe that yoga was created to try to get us out of that cycle of repetition, to the point that when we die, we would go to heaven or nirvana. I believe our souls evolve by experiencing different challenges in different lives, allowing us to grow spiritually. Yoga is a tool which can be used to bring clarity and a better sense of purpose and direction in this life. If you imagine the cycle of life, death, and rebirth, on the section of life on that cycle, we all go through pretty much the same process. We are all born in a particular time. We live our lives through a series of challenges and moments. And eventually, we will come to the end. But every challenge that we go through in life helps to build our character. It gives us experience in life. It gives and change directions in life. And it makes us who we are. And if you look back in our past, especially the difficult moments we have been through in life, you see that there were consequences to those moments. They led to something else. So all of those turns or directions that we go through in life, they were caused by those challenges. These are all part of our path towards our destiny. So eventually, if you understand that a challenge is something that is necessary for our development as human beings, a challenge will lose its negativity, and you learn how to embrace a challenge for what it is, and you learn how to see beyond the challenge. Sometimes the outcome of a challenge is not necessarily what we want, but is exactly what we need. And time always tells. Thanks to your past, you find yourself where you are now. I believe that the practice of Ashtanga Yoga is a reflection of life. If you look at the first asana of the series, Tadasana, it represents you being born or appearing in the planet. The next few asanas after that represents the next few challenges you had in your life. As you get older, it gets more intense. And at the very end, Shavasana, which translates to the corpse pose, represents the end of life. If you can interpret the practice in this way, Ashtanga Yoga will teach you how to flow during each of those challenges without allowing you to pick what you like or avoiding the ones you don't like. It teaches you how to be present, how to practice with intention, and how to be happy with what you can do, regardless of you losing your balance and falling, or being able to bind in a particular asana. Because Ashtanga Yoga is not about that. Ashtanga Yoga is about how you approach your practice with intention, acceptance, presence, and love.
For more information about Luis's teaching schedules, including his workshops, private classes, and remote classes via Skype, please get in touch via the website luisvegayoga.com.